Dr. Jeremy Weisz here. I'm founder of InspiredInsider.com, where I talk with inspirational entrepreneurs and leaders like the founders of P90 X, Baby Einstein, Atari, and many more, and how they overcome big challenges in life and business. This is part of the e-commerce mastery series where top sellers and experts teach you what really works to boost your e-commerce business. Our sponsor today is Rise25.com. If you're an entrepreneur and you want to be around other top performers to solve big challenges and form deep friendships, this is for you. It's a group of top entrepreneurs that come together to solve their biggest and your biggest business challenges and leave with lifelong friendships. Rise 25 is run by myself, John Corcoran. Check it out at rise25.com. It's an application only since we keep it to a very small group. And I want to give a shout out, thank you to Shane Stott for introducing my guest today. Today we have Brian Oakes. He's founder of GlobalGoods, where they source and manufacture agave nectar, coconut oil, and Mexican vanilla products. They produce their own natural skincare line, Cocave, C-O-C-A-V-E. They sell all over the world. And what's interesting, Brian, is you do this by also providing local jobs to struggling areas like in Africa, Asia, Dominican Republic, and many more. Thank you for joining me, first of all.
Yeah, thanks for having me on. I really appreciate it.
So I always ask, since the e-commerce mastery series, Inspired Insider, what's been the lowest business moment and how you push through, and then the proudest? What's been the lowest?
I would say that bad shipment of the coconut oil was a real tough one to overcome. That one was...
Why is that? Because it seems like you handled it pretty well and you found
it. I didn't tell you how much time it took to handle it really well. It just felt like, I was sitting there looking, calling the dump, trying to find out how much it would cost to dispose of 80 drums of oil at the local dump, and I wasn't quite sure how we were going to get through that. That was an expensive mistake. And then it felt like I couldn't trust the guys in Africa anymore, because, if I bring in another 80 drums like that, then we're toast, And so it was just those expensive mistakes when you're first starting off with things, where we invested a lot of money to get to that point, and then to have it kind of blow up on us, that was a low point for us. It ended up turning around and it was really good.
Yeah. How long did it take for you to actually then figure out, okay, we could sell it to this lotion company and they're going to use it?
It was several months.
It was.
Yeah. And, the thing is as you get older or as I'm in the business longer, when bad things happen, it doesn't freak me out nearly as much as
right.
It used to.
Yeah.
Because you look back and you just go, I could have died so many times already. Or the business could have been pushed under so many times already that this is just a blip in the radar and we'll just keep on going. We'll figure it out.
Yeah.
And so now I've got guys, that are new to the business that they see a problem and they're like, oh, this is
they're
the worst
freaking
ever.
Out. Yeah.
Like, we'll get through it. It's no big deal. And, 2 weeks later, it's fine and everybody's breathing again and whatever else.
Something lately that someone... Because there's always fires to be put out, right? What's something lately that someone freaked out about that you is just a blip to you now because you've dealt with so much?
Yeah, we just launched that I Want a Spa program, the way that we had configured everything really limited the amount of people that we could build websites for. So I revamped the entire system, because when I built the first system, that was before mobile devices and everything else was around, And so we had to redo everything. We couldn't, put a Band-Aid on that old system anymore.
Right.
And so we started to work on, all right, how do we transition the 65,000 people over to the new system? And then as we got to about 15,000 people transitioning over, all of a sudden we started seeing problems with the database. And we're like, oh, crap, we built this wrong after all these years? And so I was like, we got to tweak this. We got to do it differently.
Yeah.
We got to make some changes to it. And so... that was just a few months ago. So
proudest moment, when it's one of the proudest moments business-wise for you?
Launching that cacave line. Because before that, I mean, that in terms of a product aspect, that was one of the proudest moments. There's been many. But, you know, I always wanted to create something that no one's ever created before.
Yeah.
You know, agave, anybody with enough money can go and create agave. Coconut oil, you can bring in coconut oil. Mexican vanilla, same type of thing. I wanted to create something that no one's created before. And so I was really, really proud of that product and even more proud of how it's helping people versus just creating a product, yeah. You know? And so I really like that. But then on a personal level, I really love helping people.
Yeah.
And, you know, two times ago when we were in the Dominican Republic working on essential oils,
yeah.
we came across a family who 2 days before we arrived in the DR, their home had burned down.
Jeez.
And their home is, you know, probably the size of your office that you're sitting in.
I've been to Dominican Republic, and you know, there's, for me, the perception was there's hotels, and then there's really like small tin huts. I mean, I didn't see anything in between, and we were traveling around.
Exactly. Yeah. Yep. No, that's exactly it. And so, you know, we were able to help build a new home for that family.
Mm.
And, you know, we've helped work on other projects and homes there and built a internet cafe and that kind of thing. And so we're doing some different projects there now. And
yeah.
That's just becoming really fun.
Yeah.
Seeing that you're able to help people that yeah. had nothing before, I found that that drives me and motivates me more than all the product stuff. Those sure. are just means to an end.
Yeah. You know, talk about that because you've built those things. But what you're creating in these places is really sustainability for them.
Yeah.
What's one of those stories where you remember, you know, because of, you know, they're getting coconuts and bringing it to you and you're paying them for it, or you've created all these jobs. What's one of those stories that touched you because of all the jobs you're creating?
You know, the being able to have kids go to schools.
Yeah.
I mean, I can tell you a number of stories where, you know, you see the tears in the mother's eyes as their child is the very first child that gets to go to school.
Yeah, yeah.
And girls that are being able to go to schools in places where they never had an opportunity to before.
Yeah.
You know, in some of the schools that we help, like in the Dominican Republic, a little girl has a deformed arm, and, you know, and just seeing her having school clothes to wear, being able to participate with all the other kids and having my children go and interact with them.
That's amazing. I'm sure yeah. that they've seen so much, yeah.
You know, and we do some amazing fun things as a family when we go on these trips. We'll ride elephants, we'll pet tigers, we'll swim with sharks. You know, we've done some just amazing
yeah.
things. Most
yeah,
people,
and one of the pictures you're holding a baby tiger, like
yeah.
feeding it. I'm like, if it's a tiger, I'm not sure if I'm holding it.
If you look at the milk bottle on that one, the milk was almost gone, and I was just going, take the picture quick, because I don't want to know what he's going to do when he's out of milk.
For me, tigers are like, it's unnatural for me to be in a picture in that close proximity to a tiger. I don't care how domesticated they are.
Yeah. But the fascinating thing, after each one of these trips, I asked my children, what was your favorite thing that we did on this trip?
Yeah.
And, you know, and I just doing some of those fun things that I listed there. Every time they say it was helping the kids in this one particular village.
Yeah.
One village where we have a basketball court and we go and we play with these kids and play basketball with them, you know. And it's just so much fun. We just have so much fun and interacting and helping people and then, you know, giving my children that experience and having them appreciate it so that when we're at home and they've got the nicer things at home, they don't, you know, they appreciate those things more. Yeah.
Yeah.
And, right. and sometimes, and you know, I'll be honest, sometimes we got to remind them. It's like, you know, what would a kid in Africa say to having to eat their vegetables, you know, whatever it is. And they're like, I know, Dad, I know.
And the thing is, they've experienced that firsthand, so they do know.
You're right.
Yeah. That's amazing.
My son is soon going to try to work on his Eagle Scout Award. And so he's going, Dad, what's a project I can do in another country for his big Eagle Scout project? And so he wants to take something on himself and wants to start doing something. And so I'll be curious to see what he comes up with. But those are the types of things that I want them to learn. Yeah. And, you know, they're not afraid of race. You know, they've seen Mexican kids, they've seen black kids in Africa, or, you know, Haitian kids or Dominican Republic kids. They've seen them all, and they're not scared of them. And seeing them swing on the same swing together of a swing set that was built, you know, just, it's awesome. I love that kind of stuff.
Yeah. So, you know, for you, what's in the pipeline? What's for nations expanding? Is there anything in the pipeline you can share as far as nations that you're looking into setting up, or products? Like, what's next for you? So obviously, you're always thinking, you're always producing stuff. Yeah. So,
We could have done this call at 4 a.m. because I was up and my brain just starts kicking in and I can't sleep, you know. But I'm just always thinking about the next thing. I just barely got the I Want a Spa system up and running. And so now it's okay. Let's spend a little bit more time. The Dominican Republic is the newest country that we've started working in. So,
what are they doing there?
Working on orange oil and lemon oil. And then we're working with another group that wants to start importing cocoa beans. They have cocoa nibs that they have there and stuff. So we're looking into that as well and seeing if that's something that we want to do. And so that's going to take a few more trips to finalize something there. But that's the big one on the horizon right now.
Is that typical for you, Brian? Do you usually wake up at 4? What's your daily routine look like?
It just depends. I mean, but yeah, sometimes that happens, and I just can't stop the thought process. And I mean, I've got several notes, and I keep my phone next to my bed, which is probably dangerous. But it's like I'll wake up in the middle of the night and go, "Has anybody done that before?" And I'll just start searching for it, you know. And then I'll start making notes, and then I'll fall back asleep. Then I wake up like a truck rolled me over, you know. So I can't maintain that lifestyle like I used to, you know. But I get up pretty early. I actually coach my son's ultimate frisbee team, and every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, I put in about 3 hours in the morning of working with his team.
Really? In the morning?
Yeah, in the morning.
What time does it start?
We start at 7.
Okay.
So, yeah, I miss a little bit of work doing that. So that's another reason I'll wake up at 4 so I can start working with some of the other countries where, you know, they're awake during those times. Then I'll go to practice. Then I'll come home and get back into work and start going there. Yeah. But, you know, I got to give him props. His team won the state championship this year.
Wow. Congratulations.
We'll take it.
How old is he?
He's 14.
Okay. Wow. That's so amazing.
Yeah.
So what lesson should we leave people with? We talked a lot about different really in the trenches stories.
The thing that you got to find what you're passionate about, and you know, and the passions change, and that's okay. You know, when we first started our business, my passion was all about making money. I mean, it had to be, you know, we had to get it off the ground. And then when we had enough to meet our needs, then it was like, well, what more can we do? And so we started to help with projects in Africa or wherever. And then that was really fun. Maybe that's where the passion needs to be. That's a reason for getting out of bed in the morning. So we would focus on that, you know, and put everything that we have into that. You know, my wife, she's awesome. She's as patient can be. She knows when I get my mind set on something just to kind of let it do it, run its course. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't, you know, but I take the baseball bat and I go after it, you know.
That's true.
And I figure it out.
Yeah. Brian, thank you so much. Everyone should check out globalgoods.com. It's been great.
Appreciate it, Jeremy.